now. You think there might be something soon?
You can check back in a couple weeks if you want.
Hey.
Phone not to come over right now. If she catches you...
So what if she does? Relax. No way she'd keep us apart anymore.
I miss you so much. Believe me, I'm so ready for this to be over. You have no idea.
No, it's just that I haven't seen you in so long. I was in West Side.
I hardly left my Aunt Penny's house, thanks to my mother. 5 months.
Sorry, baby.
Doctor says it could be any time now. If it's a boy, I want to name him Luke.
Luke? Yeah, cool. That was my grandfather's name.
Yeah. I just like how it sounds with Matthew. I'm
so glad that you're back. I want to be with you for the rest of our lives.
Matt, the baby's gonna be adopted.
I thought we were gonna... Megan, this is our child. I love you.
One thing has nothing to do with the other.
I've been racking my brains, figuring it out. What we're gonna do, how we're gonna do it. What? I have.
Did you really think that we'd just become this, like, instant family?
What is up with you all of a sudden?
Matt, please.
No, tell me. This is her, isn't it? She decided this.
You're only making it worse.
Hi, sweetie. Were you out in the backyard? Careful, you might catch a chill. See you.
Good to see you too, Beverly.
I didn't think you were gonna make it. Don't leave, okay?
I'm not going anywhere.
Matthew, I really think that you should wait outside in the waiting room.
Oh.
Hang on, sweetie. Hang on.
Nurse! Nurse, can we get somebody in here now?
Nurse,
Matthew, please.
Okay, sounds like we're ready.
Excuse me, please. Excuse me.
Okay.
She's
Come on.
She's all right?
Good. Very good. Now.
You're first. It's great. Becoming a father. I can't even begin to tell you how much your life's about to change. Yeah, people say that. It's like all of a sudden, everything just clicks into place.
Well, it's over.
Is she okay? I'm gonna go see her.
No, Matt! She has just been... Just take it easy, all right? Yes, she's okay. Or she will be.
When we're married.
Matthew. I think that everything is going to be all right once you and Megan get past this and get on with your lives.
Why do you keep talking about past? I want to marry her.
I know. I know you do. But a wife and a family, Matthew, it's hard under the best of circumstances, and even you have to admit that these are not the best of circumstances. Megan should be starting college. This should be the happiest time of her life.
Hold it. Have you even asked her what she wants? Have you asked your daughter?
I don't really need to ask her, Matt. I know.
No, you don't get it. We are in love. This is our child, and we're going to make a home for it.
Paging Dr. Fraser to emerge.
Dr. Matthew, I want you to take this in the best way possible, because that is truly how I intended. But from what I know of you and your background...
This is my responsibility, and I can take care of it.
How? How can you even begin to know how to provide a home?
I said I'm gonna, and I'm gonna!
Mrs. Eubanks. Well, I had to do a little repair work, but she's fine.
I want to be able to see the baby and Megan. I'm the father.
Yes, well, they're sleeping now, but I'll leave word at the nursery. And I want her to stay for a few days, though, you know, just to keep an eye on her.
Thank you.
So, what is it? Boy or girl?
It's a boy.
Congratulations. You have a son.
Yeah.
Thanks. I have a son.
The name's Blessing, a boy. He was born this morning.
Nope. This is what I got. Maserati, Jackson, Eubanks.
Eubanks. That's him, yeah.
His head.
Hey.
That's right. Look at you. You're a natural born father.
He's smart. I mean, is he? I mean, you deal with babies a lot.
Well, I'd say he's probably exceptional.
Look,
he knows you. He knows who his daddy is.
We're sorry. You have reached a number that is no longer in service. We're sorry. You have reached a number that is no longer in service.
Right over here.
Take care.
Look at you! The prodigal son.
Hey, Barb. Is Lisa around? I tried to call, but her phone's been disconnected.
She's down the shore. Got a job in the casinos.
Are you kidding? My mom left here? When?
A couple of weeks.
She's worked here forever.
Yeah. Here. Leave your address or something. She'll be back, I'm sure. She's got a check waiting.
That's where I'm living. Hey, if you do see her, tell her she's grandmother.
Oh, good for you. What you got?
Son.
Oh, well, hey, good for you.
You're sure there's no problem? I mean, with the baby's father.
Right now, he's not in any position. No. There's no problem.
See you in 2 days then, kiddo.
We'll give him a good home, Megan. A good life.
Who are they? Friends of your mom's? Have you seen him yet?
No, and I don't plan to.
I just keep going back and just staring. He's like this little person. He's gonna be running around raising hell before you know it. Have you given any more thought? To us. I want to marry you, Megan. I know we'd manage okay.
Manage to become a statistic. Matt, you don't even have a job anymore.
I'm gonna get one.
If I got married now, I'd be divorced by the time I was 20. I mean, I've practically missed my entire senior year. I just want to get out of here and see people again. Have some fun.
Don't you just feel awful doing this?
It hasn't exactly been a snap decision. My mind's made up.
So if you do this, do they at least tell you who's gonna take them?
I already know. It's all settled.
What do you mean? Well, who is it? What, those two people who were just in here?
Matt, I want him to go to a family that can give him a home. A good home. With these people, he can have brothers and sisters and do... be anything.
He already is. He's our son. I don't get how you can just give him away like this.
Well, I can. Or I will, as soon as I sign the consent, but I can't do that for 7 days.
I'm not signing nothing, so forget it.
You don't have to.
I'm the father.
We're not married, so legally, it's my kid, not ours.
No, that's not right.
Believe me, Matt, that's the way it is.
Sweetie.
Lisa. How did you get in?
The guy down at the desk. I showed him pictures of you I have in my wallet.
You don't have pictures of me, Mom. So what the hell happened anyway? You quit your job? You move away?
I got a good gig in the casinos. I got a place with a view of the ocean. Come on, let's not do this, okay? It's been, what, almost 2 years? But you came looking for me. That means a lot to me, honey. So this girl, is she your girlfriend?
I met her about a year ago. She was helping out the receptionist at this doctor's clinic I was laying carpet at. She's got it all settled. Our baby's being adopted by these rich people so that they can give them stuff, everything.
Good for him. And you, it's best you put this all behind you.
Thanks for your motherly advice.
What is up with you?
You know, I have a kid and I can't turn my back on him. I know that's hard for you to understand. That seems to be how we express our love in this family.
I didn't desert you. If I recall, you were the one who had to get out on his own.
I was already on my own. I've always been on my own.
Matt, it wasn't exactly easy raising a kid by myself. Oh, damn it. Remember when you were little and we used to pile into the car and we would drive and drive and we'd only stop and get out when we wanted to? You remember that?
The time we went to Gramps? I still dream about that.
Yeah, me too. I wake up screaming.
You ever think of seeing her? She's your family.
I have to go. I got a train to catch. Here. Let me give you this. Please. No, I want you to have it. Please, Matt. See? You were such an independent little boy. Just like me. I'll see you.
Taken him, haven't they?
No, but soon. He's in there with his mother right now.
That's great.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Hey, don't think you're taking my kid.
Maybe there's some confusion.
Henry! Oh, oh. You have no right! You're not taking my son!
It's okay, honey.
You okay?
You said you weren't gonna see him.
Can't keep him, Matt. I don't have any choice.
You know, when they said he was down here, I thought maybe you were having a change of heart. Like we'd all leave here together.
I have to take him back now. I have to see what he looks like.
He looks like us. Look, he may not be the smartest guy in the world. But I know one thing. This whole thing is wrong.
Please don't make this any harder.
Wait. I'm leaving. I'll take him. You peed on me. Hey, I got formula and diapers.
disposable. They didn't have these when my kids were babies. Oh, no, this is too cold. They're gonna come looking for you, don't you?
Yeah, we gotta clear out of here, like right now.
You got someplace you can take them?
Else, but I'm gonna do that. I didn't hear you there.
I didn't mean for you to.
It's me, Matt.
Matt who?
Matt Blessing, your grandson.
I see who you are.
Been so long. Everything's just like I remember.
Are you in some kind of trouble? That's a newborn. What are you doing with it?
He's my kid. His mother wanted to put him up for adoption, and no way was I gonna let that happen, so I took him.
Well, you're gonna have to take him right back. In case you haven't noticed, this family doesn't have any aptitude in that department.
It's okay, he's my son.
Well, that doesn't necessarily mean it's okay for you to have him.
Megan doesn't want to raise him. Why does that mean that I can't? Because I'm a guy? Because I'm never gonna be good enough?
That's not up to me to decide. You're going to have to return that baby, or you're going to be in trouble if you're not already.
No, I can't. This is my son, and I'm not going to turn my back on him. I know what that feels like, and it's not fair.
Okay, you can stay. For tonight, anyway.
Thanks, Graham. Hey, I didn't tell you. His name's Luke. Like Grandpa's.
Oh, me.
Morning, Glennie.
Hi, Bert.
Yeah, let me help you with this.
Oh, thanks.
How about coming into town for some breakfast?
Can't. Got company. My grandson.
Well, he must be all grown up. Wasn't that nice he came to visit?
I'll let you know when he's gone.
Yeah.
baby. Morning, bud. How you doing? Sleep well.
He's okay. I just wanted you to know.
Matt, tell me where you are. What do you know about babies?
Hell of a lot more than I did 24 hours ago.
Matt, you stole our baby.
Don't. Don't say it like that.
You won't get away with it.
Okay. But I'm still gonna raise our son, even if it's never gonna happen for us.
Matt, I'm just not ready.
Is that Matthew? Give me the phone. Don't give me the phone. Matthew? Matthew, you bring that baby back.
I think that's okay.
What do you mean you think it's okay?
Listen, the last time I bathed a baby, Nixon was in office. No, I think that's good. You get the temperature right, then you unwrap him. Support his neck.
Kate.
It's all right if I cried a little bit.
Hey, what is going on here?
Jim. Matt, this is Jim Benson. He's got that Christmas tree farm up the road. And Jim, this is my daughter's boy, Matt and Luke.
Hey, Matt. Hey, good to meet you. I didn't know you had a daughter, Glennie. Much less grandsons.
Well, I'm a woman of mystery.
Yeah, well, I just wanted to let you know that got your drainage ditch cleared out. Ought not to flood again.
What I'd do without you, Jim. Thanks.
Yeah, well, it's always something, isn't it?
Yeah.
You gotta stay on top of it.
Yeah.
You staying long?
Not really.
That baby's awfully young. What'd you say the mother is?
The boys are just staying with me for a while. She's getting settled in her new place.
You say you got a tree farm.
Oh, yeah, that's right. 200 acres.
You need any extra help? I've been kind of looking for something.
Oh, sure. Any relation to Glennie's got to be a hard worker. Glennie? You stop up, Matt, and we'll talk about putting you to work while you're here.
I will, thanks.
Hey, rip that baby or you'll be sorry.
I want to be able to pay our keep.
If we can stay a while.
Oh. Oh, dear.
Hey, Charlie. This is Matt.
Cornwell's grandson.
Take a seat.
He's gonna be working with us today. Charlie's making us omelets. Irving Gruyere.
Sounds good to me.
Go on, take a seat.
Great omelet. You ever think about being a chef?
I do trees, basically.
Just a suggestion. You're wasting your talent.
You're wasting our time. You probably haven't had to work this hard since the day you were born.
Charlie, we'll toughen him up.
I don't know what to do. The more I try, the more pissed off he gets at me.
Oh, don't take it personally. He just doesn't know you well enough yet. Oh, look. It's Larry, the police. I'll see what he wants.
Hey, Glennie.
How you doing?
Hi, Glennie.
Larry. I'm fine.
Got any visitors of our years?
Just my grandson.
Call me if you see anything.
I'll be sure to call. Okay. People around here talk. There's a baby missing.
Are they taking him back?
No. I told them you were my two grandsons staying here. What on earth is wrong with
me? Graham, if it wasn't for you, I'd have to take him back.
I'm lying to the police. I'm too old to start lying.
You think I came here to hide out? You are my family. You and Luke. I got no place else to go. We're okay, thanks.
I'm Pam. Pam Kelly. You from around here somewhere, or are you lost?
No, thanks.
Okay, then.
We're gonna have to have a talk. That baby should have been fed over an hour ago. Babies need to keep to a schedule.
Sure, okay.
And you need to get that baby to a doctor.
I do? Why? What's wrong with him?
Well, there's nothing wrong with him. He's a baby. And babies need to be checked over regularly. And there are also shots he needs to be getting. You're the father.
I know I'm his father.
Well, Mr. Take some responsibility and start acting like it.
Say try a vacuum cleaner. That ought to mellow him out.
Who says?
His book. Listen to this. Extend your forearm palm up. Place baby on your arm, chest down, with his head in your hand, and legs on either side of your elbow.
Really?
We'll see.
Yeah. Like that?
Guess. Support baby with your other hand and walk around with him in this position. It does work. God, I had no idea what went into this. This is so intense.
You need a break. Here. Go get this stuff. Take my car. And I'll take Luke. Come on, honey. Come on, honey. Yeah. Hey, bye-bye. Bye-bye. Hey, bye-bye, Daddy. Bye-bye. Bye, Daddy.
Hi, Pam.
stranger. What you doing with Glennie Cornwell's car?
She's my grandma.
Glennie Cornwell's your grandmother. Mystery solved. So we're having a special on pork chops today, in case you're interested. It's my family business.
Good to know. I mean, about the pork chops.
Yeah. Well, I can tell you exactly how many I've had to sell to get my one-way ticket out of here.
That's for my baby brother, Luke.
Baby. Right.
So you say you're leaving this place?
Yeah, soon.
How come?
Because I can tell you what my life will be like if I don't. You know, get married, have kids. And then someday, my husband and I get to take over the family business.
That sounds pretty good to some people.
Yeah. Well, Bracebridge starts at one end of the street, ends at the other, and everyone knows what's going on in between.
Hi, Pam.
Hi. I rest my case.
Yeah. Everyone's staring.
Because they're not used to seeing strangers. Or because you're with me and they think I'm like Madonna's love child or something. Or because you're Glennie Cornwell's grandson and they just want to get a closer look.
Why?
You know, I admire the way she lives her life. She's so self-sufficient, but some people think that she's eccentric.
Well, she's lived alone out there for a long time. That'll do that to people.
What, living alone or living out there?
Living alone, cut off from people, family. Actually, living in the city can be pretty lonely, too.
So, I'm leaving this place real soon. And I was thinking, why don't you come with me? We can go anywhere you want.
Could we bring Luke?
Luke, what do you want to bring your brother for?
Never mind, just forget it.
What's up with you?
Nothing. I gotta go.
fire truck. Or I would have been down here to help.
Do you have any idea how this started? What was Glennie's story down here?
I've been telling Glennie for the longest. This place is a lot for a woman to handle all by herself. Your right hands? It's a gold mine.
You mean your hands? You started this fire. I saw you.
No, you didn't.
We could have been hurt or killed. You think about us?
Yeah, what about you? What about you? That baby's no more your brother than I am. You think we're a bunch of hicks around here? Cops would love to know about you and that kid.
That's my business.
Yeah, and this is my business. So we both mind our own business and nobody gets hurt. Got it. Things were just fine till you showed up.
Breakfast ready! Hi, Jim! You staying for breakfast?
I don't. I gotta go, Bert. Oh, tell Glennie if she needs anything.
She's getting on to the insurance people. They're gonna be looking into this, I guess.
Bert, why don't you go home? You're making me nervous.
Don't usually see boys so attentive to babies. It's amazing how he takes care of his little brother like that.
Yes, it is. It's amazing.
Okay. I guess that's all done.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
See you.
Out for the count. You might get some sleep.
I'm uneasy about this.
What do you mean?
Keeping Luke here like this.
I don't know what else I'm supposed to do.
Get it out in the open. Get legal custody of him.
Nobody's gonna give me custody.
Maybe not. But maybe they would. What you did last night. How you handled the situation. How you handled Luke. You made sure this baby was safe. If you want to raise this child, you're going to have to deal with it now. Not later on. We have to deal with it now. If it's what you want.
Okay. Yeah, Graham, it is.
Then I say let's go for it. You and me. Bert, I'm sorry I couldn't go into all this before.
There's no need, Glennie. I understand.
Didn't know you were a lawyer, Bert.
Oh, yeah. I haven't practiced in a while, but I'm still a member of the bar. Now, first, we have to find out if the young lady has signed the adoption papers and if she's filed against you for violating her custody rights.
Her rights? She wanted to give them away.
Yes, that may be where we have a chance for violating your rights.
What?
You're the father. You have rights. Parental rights.
I do.
Bert, he does?
Oh, yeah. Yes, he does. Until such time as they're extinguished by the court. I think we can show that she was attempting to violate your rights by signing over custody.
Hey.
But you did interfere with her rights when you took the child. And no judge is going to be too pleased with that. So you would have to be prepared to...
Lose him.
To lose him, yeah.
So Bert's a lawyer, huh?
20 years ago, he was a well-respected attorney in this county.
Sure couldn't tell by looking at him.
Well, now, you know, there's a lot you can't tell just by looking at people.
Lenny Cornwell, how in the world are you?
Marge.
Excuse me.
Sure wish you'd make one of our homemakers meetings.
Marge, you know I never was one much for clubs.
Hey. Here you got the best pork chops in town.
So this is Luke.
Yeah. I got a lot of responsibilities right now.
I know what that's like.
I'd like to see you again.
Okay. Maybe.
Hey, Matt.
Your mom should be taking that little brother off your hands any day now.
Hey, Pam.
Jim?
Bet you can't wait.
What was that about?
Listen, I gotta go.
Okay.
What's wrong? You don't like Pam Kelly, do you?
I don't know her. I think she's too good for Bracebridge, Pennsylvania, seems to me.
I thought you said you didn't know her.
I know the type. She's never going to be satisfied.
You're talking about Mom, aren't you?
I don't talk about your mother. This is Mr. Grant from Liberty Insurance.
I was reviewing Mrs. Cornwell's claim. I want to talk to you if I could.
Police were here the morning of the fire. I told them everything.
Yes, I have your statement. I was just wondering if you might have anything to add, if you remembered anything.
No.
Well, should you?
Your friend is here.
Okay, thanks. I'll be right there.
He likes you.
Yeah. Is that why he's drooling? Yeah. I guess he's okay. I mean, if you're into babies.
Pam, Luke's mine. He's my, he's my kid. My son. She wanted to put him up for adoption, and no way was I going to let that happen, so I brought him here.
You mean you just took him?
It's like my whole life, I've always been so pissed. My dad, and my mom, the world. Because I always felt like nobody cared enough. Nobody could be bothered enough. And now I have this son, and I have a chance to change all that. That's why I gotta stay here and figure out how to keep him.
Well, you have to go to the police. You know, you need to tell them everything. About everything.
You're right. I gotta tell him everything. No matter what.
Bracebridge Place.
Yeah, yes. My name's Matt Blessing. I'm Glennie Cornwell's grandson.
Oh, yeah.
I'm up at the lodge.
What can we do for you?
I have something to tell you.
Larry? Is there a problem? Matthew's my client.
Client? Why you said that, Bert? You sound just like a lawyer.
He is a lawyer. He's my lawyer.
That's right, Larry. I'm his attorney.
Well, then, Matt here's just give me his statement.
What?
Now, Matt, it was dark. Are you sure it was Benson?
Oh, I'm sure. He wants this place. He was trying to scare us off. He didn't think I would go to the police.
Just a minute. What's all this about Benson?
We were pretty sure he was mixed up in the fire. Now we got a witness. Your testimony will have to stand up in court.
I know. It will.
Glennie? Wait.
Something else I gotta tell you.
What's that?
Has to do with my son. What'd he say, Bert?
A couple of things. In cases like this, social services will probably want to put Luke into foster care until the matter is resolved.
No, they can't do that.
I'm sorry.
But Luke is already settled here. Why can't he stay here with me?
Well, normally he could. But you lied to the police when they came asking. But here's a point to get. Megan never signed those adoption papers.
She didn't.
No, she didn't. And now she's suing to terminate your custody rights. And until there's a judgment in her favor, you still have those rights. So now's the time to file for sole custody.
Okay.
They're going to be inclined to work with you on this because of the information about Benson. Hey, you coming forward is going to help.
So there's going to be a trial?
A hearing, yeah. But there's not much we can do till then.
Luke in foster care should have kept my mouth shut.
Oh, in all my years as a lawyer. Well, I know that doesn't work. If you've got the guts to tell the truth, you're way ahead of most people.
Hey. Did you have a bad dream? It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Shh. It's okay. Daddy's here.
Did you ever know my dad?
Oh, I wouldn't say I really knew him. Lisa never. No. No, I really didn't.
Sunday mornings were always the best. And when we'd get up early, we'd always go do something. Just us. One Sunday I woke up and Mom said he'd gone. Thought she meant he'd just taken off without me. And she screamed, "He's gone and he's never coming back." She ran into their room and slammed the door. That's all she ever told me. I was 7. Told the kids at school he was dead. Sometimes I wish I could find him, you know, and just like knock the hell out of him. And you know, like ask him, how could you do that to a little kid that loved you? How could you do that? Leave me. He's a hunk. He's a hunk baby.
Careful.
He's in the 75 percentile for height. He's in the 75 percentile for weight. In another month or two, we'll start him on cereal. Whoa, cereal.
Wheaties. Babies don't eat Wheaties.
Can't lose him, Graham. Hey, Bert, grab some stew.
Thanks. I had my dinner.
Yeah, it's excellent. Matt was just about to tell us what his secret ingredient was.
Uh-uh.
Yes.
Bert, sit down. What is it, Bert? Come on. We're all on the same side here.
Social services have decided to put Luke into foster care until the custody hearing. He's going to be placed with a good family. Down in Beth Peterson. He's a postmaster here. They're real nice folks.
These people where you're going, they like little kids. You're gonna be cool with them. And Graham and me, we're gonna come visit you. Oh, and we're gonna bring you stuff.
When I first held you, you like fit in my hand. You know what you did? You looked me straight in the eye. Like you knew right then who I was. That I'm always gonna look out for you. I'm gonna. I promise you. Our whole lives, buddy. I'm always gonna.
Matt, it's time.
Hi, Matt. I'm Haley Novak, social worker on this case. And you must be Luke.
Yes.
Hi, Luke.
Graham, did you get his bear? He's got this little bear that...
It's in the bag.
Well, we better be going.
Could fix us a grilled cheese.
What if I never see him again? What am I gonna do?
Your suitcase. How you holding up?
Okay. Get to see him on Saturday. Then it's up to the judge.
But you're doing the right thing. I mean, they gotta see that. All I ever wanted was to get out of this place. And then now.
You're doing what you need to do.
And you're doing what you need to do.
Tree should be standing in the forest, not in my living room. How are we supposed to get around it?
You know, that's a very antisocial game.
Then it's perfect for me, isn't it?
What is with you, anyway? You know what your problem is? You're so afraid of getting close to anyone. To me. To Mom. Definitely to Mom.
You're so afraid that if you let yourself get close to your own family...
Why don't you keep your theories to yourself? You don't know nearly enough about me.
I think I do.
Your mom's the one. Oh, why even go into it?
The one who what? No, come on, let's go into it.
When she brought you here that time, you think that was for a visit? She didn't give a darn about me or paying me a visit. All she wanted was a place to unload you. When that idea lasted 24 hours, then she remembered what a rotten mother she thought I was. And then the two of you were on the first bus out of here.
That's not true.
All these years I've been managing. I've been managing almost to forget. Until you showed up.
Mom.
Matt, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm in Bracebridge.
You're in Bracebridge?
You heard right. I brought Luke. I'm fighting for custody. I don't know what's gonna happen.
I'm going to court on the 21st.
Mom, when we came here that time...
To see the evil witch.
Come on, Mom, just don't.
Don't what?
I wish you two could just sit down and talk.
I will never sit down with her, not after what she said to me.
All that's history. We gotta get past it. Forgive and forget.
Did she tell you to say that?
No. She's stubborn, just like you. But I know that she loves you. Mom, Glennie would never say it, but we both wish you were here.
Well, anyway, have a Merry Christmas. Have a good one.
Yeah, you too. Merry Christmas. Charlie, when did you start on here?
Gonna order something?
I'll have a coffee. Make these muffins?
Do you think I want to talk to you? My pop's sitting in jail this Christmas because of you.
Charlie, he tried to burn Glennie out.
It's a buck.
I feel bad, Charlie, but I had to do it. It took having a kid to make me realize what's important. I gotta own up to what's what. Sorry. Thanks.
That was a nasty thing I did. Your mother was only doing the best she knew how.
I know. Let's just forget about it, okay?
I'm sorry. Grandmothers are supposed to be these sweet little ladies who make cookies and spice cakes. And stuffing, for heaven's sake. Stuffing!
I like you exactly the way you are.
Good. I like you too.
Cornwell?
Yes.
I'm Beth Peterson. You probably don't remember me.
Oh, sure I do. This is my grandson, Matt.
Hey, Matt. Well, come on in. We've been expecting you.
Well, look who's here, Luke. Look who came to see you.
Hey, buddy. How are ya?
Hiya. You know, I remember in junior high, I was in Lisa's class, and a bunch of us spent the night at your lodge.
Oh, yeah. I remember scraping marshmallows out of the fireplace for days.
Oh. I'll be in the kitchen.
Who's that?
Who's that? Is that Graham? Is that Graham?
I want to get a picture.
Picture?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, you're a big boy now. You're big.
Of course he knows you.
He knows who I am.
You miss this part?
Here.
Graham, no, we said we weren't going to do this.
Just open it. Come on.
It's not even Christmas yet. It's Dad.
Handsome, isn't he? Just like you. The first time he came to the door here, I thought some movie star had taken a wrong turn. Your mom sure was in love with him.
Why did he leave?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe they were just too different. Maybe he didn't know how to be a dad. You know, they don't give you instructions when you have a child. I sure could have used some with Lisa. When I watch you and Luke, I think, how did he get to be such a wonderful father with duds like us?
You're not a dud. You're the first person in the world that ever stood by me. Thanks for this. I wish there was something I could give you.
I've got all I want. You're here. And no matter how things turn out, I want you to stay. This is your home.
Blessing is hereby petitioning the court for sole custody rights of the child Luke from the birth mother, Megan Eubanks. Counselor?
So you are asking the court to terminate custody rights of the child's father, Matthew Blessing?
Yes, sir.
And to have the child made a ward of state so he can be adopted outside the family?
Yes. I honestly think the right thing, the best thing, is for him to be adopted into a nice family, a normal family.
But you didn't sign over Luke's custody?
No, sir.
Nor did you press charges right away?
Why didn't you?
I just didn't.
You weren't completely convinced. Do you have any other reason for preferring adoption to his father having custody?
I can't look after him. I mean, I'm planning on going to college, and how can I? I just want to get on with my life. And if Luke is with Matt, it still won't be over.
How can you call it his child? He didn't give up 9 months of his life.
Mrs. Eubanks.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. But Matt's background. I mean, where are his role models, and how is he going to provide for this child?
No further questions.
Honestly, I don't understand why we even have to go through this exercise.
So why didn't you call the police?
Well, I almost did. But then I realized that maybe he used poor judgment. But his heart was in the right place. He loves that baby. And not only loves, he wants him to be safe and secure. And he wants him to grow up with decent values. I'm proud of the way Matt takes care of his son. And I'll be there to help him, as long as he needs me to be.
Matthew Blessing.
Why did you take the baby out of the hospital?
I think now it was wrong to take him like that. A lot could have happened to a little baby. But I've never been sorry. I wouldn't have had this chance to keep him if I hadn't have brought him to Graham's.
Matthew, let me just ask you. What would you say was a father?
Until I got to be one, I guess I had this picture of a father being someone who knows all the answers, knows all the reasons for stuff. But parents, I found out, parents are only people. A father has to be a man his child can look up to and respect and trust to always stick by him. You asked before why I took him, and I took him because I wanted a family. I never really had one. So when Megan got pregnant, I was really happy because I thought I was finally going to have a chance to have that. But things didn't work out with us. And as rough as that was, we had this little boy. And I looked at him, and it was like the world made sense. I made sense. I made him a promise that I was always going to look out for him, and I want to keep that promise. He deserves that. Thank you for not signing the adoption papers. Thank you.
I don't think you and I should be talking to each other right now.
I would like to commend all of you in the way that you've spoken truthfully. I believe that each one of you, in your own way, had Luke's best interests at heart. The court uses three factors in determining the custody of a child. The emotional ties that are already in place between the child and those claiming custody. Blood relationships. And the time that the child has spent in a stable environment. Accordingly, I think it's in the best interest of this child that he be raised by his father, a young man who has shown strong emotional ties for his son from the time that that baby was born. My ruling is that the father retains custody of this child.
Great job, Bert.
I didn't know I still had it in me.
Thank you.
You're home, buddy. You're home for good.
Oh, Matt. Oh, my gosh. Baby. Oh, honey, bring him in. He's sleeping.
Let's all go sing some carols, huh?
Okay.
Not you.
Play the piano?
Play. I've heard your voice.
See if your old hands are up to it.
Yeah. He can sing on my
God rest you, merry gentlemen. Da 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 da. Silent night, holy night, all is calm.
Mom, you're here. I figured that once we finish with the painting of the rooms and all the plumbing stuff, we'll have the lodge open by midsummer.
Honey, this is amazing.
I wanted so bad to do something with my life, and I found it right here.
You know, they say that you pass on your mistakes to your kids. I guess I broke the mold. I was such a screw-up. Yeah, I was.
You know, Mom, when I'm with Luke, the way I feel about him, it reminds me of us. You and me.
I am so proud. I can't tell you how proud I am of you right now.
Hello,
wanna
baby.
Sing?
That was...
Huh?
What's she doing here?
She's here to be with us. Graham, she's your daughter.
Yeah, I know. You're a redhead. Suits you.
Mom?
Mom? This is your grandson. This is Luke.
My goodness. Hello, Luke. Oh,